In this video, we're going to discuss the AWS Well-Architected Framework. Specifically, we will discuss what is the AWS Well-Architected Framework, the strengths and weaknesses of the AWS Well-Architected Framework, and how you might use the AWS Well-Architected Framework in your cloud architecture or solution architecture practice. So to begin, what is the AWS Well-Architected Framework? Well, it's a series of best practices and guidelines from AWS designed to assist cloud architects in designing secure, high-performing, resilient, and efficient architectures on AWS. And it comes from AWS and is based on several pillars. There are pillars called operational excellence, security, reliability, performance efficiency, cost optimization, and sustainability. And they're pretty obvious what they are. And it's going to have some recommendations from AWS on those types of goals. Now, here's the good. This framework was created by AWS to be used on AWS, so we don't have to worry about its credibility. And because AWS knows their systems well, the guidance will help with getting the systems to run from a technical perspective. And that's a good thing, but isn't enough. Here's where the AWS Well-Architected Framework lacks. The first one is related to architecture failures. So there's approximately 70 to 80% of all technology projects where they fail. And what I mean by fail is the technology works, meaning the systems are up, but they provide no value to the business. And that's typically because someone focused on the tech first and then tried to figure out how it would be used in the business, as opposed to someone looking at the business's vision and how the business operates and wants to operate, and then figuring the best technology for that business and its unique needs. Now, the weakness here with the Well-Architected Framework is it doesn't really evaluate the business at all. So there's nothing in the AWS Well-Architected Framework to prevent against the 70 to 80% architecture failures. That doesn't mean we shouldn't use it. It just means where we use it might actually vary. I recommend using an enterprise architecture framework like TOGAF. And then as we start designing our architectures and we go from higher level architectural building blocks to lower level solutions building blocks, that's where we would integrate, say, the AWS Well-Architected Framework for those solution building blocks. Now, the next thing where the AWS Well-Architected Framework is a little lacking is actually in the way it makes some recommendations. So the AWS Well-Architected Framework tends to make certain recommendations. Use managed services whenever possible, use serverless when possible, those types of things. But they're making these recommendations without the context of the business's needs or the business's goals. And that is the equivalent of going to a physician and before they've ever spoken to you, met you, or examined you, them having a pill ready for you. And when we look at architecture failures, again, we're not mirroring them back to the need. We're picking a technology of choice. We like the tech and we're marrying the tech, and then we're going to figure out how it's going to be used. So again, not only is it not optimal for the business, but it may not be the optimal technology. Sometimes for a high volume, high transaction workload, the mainframe is still the best performance today. Sometimes it's serverless. Sometimes it's microservices. Sometimes it's a monolith. We don't know until we know the business's needs. So that's kind of a weakness here of the AWS Well-Architected Framework, and a pretty large weakness. The next major weakness that I see is that it's not real world in some ways. So the AWS Well-Architected Framework, when you read through it, they give you various situations and they're recommending an AWS product that could fit that bill. And that's a good thing. I don't blame them. I'd do the same thing if I was trying to sell AWS services. I'd list my solutions. But that's not the reality of the real world. The real world is an average enterprise might have over 50,000 IP addresses, maybe 5 or 10,000 routes in the routing table that their networking team has to deal with. They may have 200 to 1,000 business applications, 50, 100 different vendors that they have to integrate with. And I could go on and go on and go on. And we need something that's going to work with the more natural, more industrial tooling that's out there. So it's not that this isn't good. It provides us some AWS context of things we might even consider as a replacement. And it also still gives us, you know, frameworks to meet those pillars. And it's a good thing. but it lacks a little bit there. So let's talk about where it's good, where it's bad, and then how we integrate them. The AWS Well-Architected Framework is great at making AWS technology work in the AWS environment. It lacks in the customized recommendations for the client. It lacks in the digital transformation and evaluation of the business piece. So maybe we marry them together. So we start and use Zachman, use TOGAF10, use any consulting or enterprise architecture framework you like. But as long as we're evaluating where the business wants to go, and we know how the business operates and how they want to operate, after that, we can align its people, processes, and technology. And again, when it comes to the technology specifics on AWS, we can go back to the AWS Well-Architected Framework. So I hope you've enjoyed this video on the AWS Well-Architected Framework. If you have a desire to become a cloud architect or an enterprise architect or an AI architect or a security architect, check out the description of this video. We have free ebooks to help you get started in your career, free webinars to help you in your architecture career, and they're on Zoom so we can meet and we can even have a conversation, and I'd love to meet you. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your enterprise architecture or cloud architecture career or AI architecture career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now. Hope to see you soon.